Department of Veterinary Pharmacology and Toxicology from Shumaga Veterinary College. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together and welcome Dr. Nadur.
My teachers, icons in poultry industries, my colleagues, decision makers, and my good friends. I was privileged to do this seminar because, particularly on this day, because when the Gopal Reddy organizer called me, it is somewhere around the first day or second week of January, something like that. Then they postponed because of this event, which is figured out by 3 months. I just remember Dr. Devo because when he moved to HSR layout during the early days, I don't know who is bigger at that time. I was just a first year university student. There was a phone call to my same hostel sending me and another student in surgery, Dr. Dinesh. Urgently attend some pet animal GH disorders in his house. He brought a 1-month-old pet at that time. The moment we touched animal, he told, "Dr. Boys, are you giving antibiotic?" I just remember when they called, that means he was having knowledge of antibody in the primitive stage before its use in the extensive importing industry. Well, I may not risk, it's impossible to cover every aspect of poultry, use of antibiotics and various drugs. But to be frank, today we cannot live not only poultry, without cattle meat, or goat, or sheep, or even fish. But what we are facing in poultry is ineligible, I can say, compared to fish also, because you are exporting fish 20 to 30 or 40,000 crores every year from India. There you may surprise, in the marine fish or the inland fish, the drugs are reaching, the drugs which are banned in India also you can find in marine or in freshwater fishes, including diclofenac. I'm talking the government report, and in that direction also the government is seriously awareness programs and containment because the totally unorganized sector were met very unsubscribed by not by veterinarians or qualified persons, and despite we don't have fish medicine as a separate meaning in India. But still, it is usually extensive. And that is also responsible for spread of resistance, not only in human beings, but also across the species. As you know, antibiotic when naloxone discovered in 1928, within 8 years, he himself declared in St. Mary's Hospital, one day the antibiotic may not be useful for the whole world if it is misused. I got the cutting of the newspaper at that time, which was published in the Britain, 1937, where one day this antibiotic will wipe out by bacteria itself. I might have discovered and got Nobel Prize, but it will be wiped out. So that is what I am telling even today. Multi-drug resistant species, even in India, South India, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, it is rampant, and the MIC value, all of you know, who are already working in industry, is growing to a significant level, where most of the high-class antibiotic, what you call broad-spectrum, later generation, or whatever the term from business angle we do, it is getting developed resistance, not only in poultry from the sector, but also in the human medicines, and it is, that is the reason why most of us are admitting for minor ailment to a nursing home or a intensive care unit. That is the alarming situation we have achieved. As you know, the growth of poultry industry in 2020, enormous growth, whether it's a sheep industry, meat, or poultry, or fish, country like India, always in the top six, whether you take irrespective of meat, except milk, in terms of export, I'm talking. That's how we are achieving significant growth in poultry industry, and we should not forget, when you talk about data, always we talk about organized sector. The problem comes, much of the problem comes unorganized sector we never look into. If this is one of the examples I want to tell you, one of the latest from Government of India, where the broader indication along in 2015 about 60%, but the antibiotic use is 50%. But where is the data about unorganized sector, which contribute a lot, where use of antibiotic is almost 90%, whether required or not. That is missing in this particular chart. So because ultimately bacteria are more differentiated with organized sector or unorganized sectors. So we have to think about when policy makers have to think a comprehensive approach, particularly when releasing the data for the public, because without this actual data, we cannot contain the spread of resistance of the use of antibiotic in general and also in poultry industry in particular. As you know, compared to our country, you tell me European Union, most of our teachers also taught in my undergraduate days. Today they have productive. 2006 onwards, they are using disease-free zones and what is known as antibiotic-free poultry meat options, particularly in European Union. Today, even some of our industries also exporting to European Union, zero concentrations. And if that some of the drugs, MRI, maximum residual limit is zero predicted. That means that is totally banned, these antibiotics. Unfortunately, in India, what happens, whether required or not, what all the antibiotics where there is market is declining in human sector, the push and prioritization in poultry has not been carried. To keep it frank, even chloramphenicol or nitrazone, where advanced countries, America, Canada banned 30 years back, still today it is not taken from the human market, not to speak about poultry alone. Because in the human public health sector, we are doing, India is a poor country in that sense. For the general public, we cannot take out nitrocolosis and chloramphenicol even in human sector, despite we are having costly and endotoxin, neurotoxin, modernization, antibiotics. The government has not taken a put up a decision in that respect. We cannot expect more nitrogen even in poultry industry. Even if you remove, there will be resistance coming across from the related antibiotics, the older generation antibiotics. As a pharmacology fellow, when you hand the sample, an emergency, including I may be telling other way to the fellow, my colleagues or students sometime, where one of the older generation antibiotics was today in India, because it was not restricted in animal use, particularly in poultry industry or in cattle manufacturing. Let me talk about chloramphenicol or reproductive disorder. It is so small, that means highly efficient within 6 or 7 months, various commercial brand name approaches and ultimately just the poultry also, fish also, and chicken goat also, and lactating in those differentiate. That is the major reason of development. So, when you call the farm-to-farm class set, whether it is available in the market is the biggest question. Not so, you can get it whatever you want, you can get it overnight. And the major problem is what level you should include it. You don't have to call it at the farm level. That is the first priority. We cannot reach it totally, but definitely we have to do it. There is no other. But thing is, we should have to give importance to actually minimum laboratory facilities, even in smaller farms also, because many a time, salmonella, E. coli, whatever it is, we will be using a wrong antibody, or if it is using a correct antibody, also proper ration we are not including in the diet or in the water, and many a time, it is wasted also, unable to contain the infection because the MIC level is low, because you don't have the ABS to the sensors, and often copy of the literature. Remember, already I think last time on the colleague also spoke about it, Dr. Kiran, there is a lot of study for the, at least for this farm sake. The MIC value, I will show many results in the Shumoga. The MIC value of particular antibody also at Chintu or Gulbarga is not same. It has keep on the same equal, same serotype today. Resistance level will be tremendously. If it is 0.1 microgram, MIC is 0.1 microgram thermally bigger. It may be 0.235 also in a single day. That means population of bacteria is different. Exposure level. More you expose, more resistance level. That is why. But our prescription dose is same. When it is not responding, we add, and that is why our side we are wasting your drugs, other side we are polluting the environment through the aspirator, through the poultry waste or the meat, we are spreading the infections. Why we are adding more and more? Because there is no infection is not cured, so we have to use higher level of antibiotic or higher antibiotic we are using. Although we can use the old generation antibiotic effectively, we are carried away by use of higher generation antibiotic, thinking that it is highly active. It is fast. Many infections, even today, large animals also, you know, my colleagues are here, large animals, what is happening, mastitis control or metritis control is a big problem. More than poultry, we got big problem in lactating cause, especially in KMO people or government sectors, where milk production adversely affected by mastitis. Because whatever route we try, whatever the way we like, we used it. Although company didn't label, extra label direction, we are using the drugs. Same in poultry also, because unless we have extension education programs, the small smaller sectors through the big farms owners on appropriate government support and a concrete policy. Even today, government policy is the containment of antibiotic use. Recently, as a government of India, I think Dr. Mahesh should be talking about that. Policies are there, but implementation becomes very difficult because we have to educate the farmers at the ground level. That is most urgently required, and any amount of lecture like this may not work unless we demonstrate effectively the benefit of not using antibiotic at the farm level is need of the hour. Antibiotic resistance, antibiotic residues, another big problem. Market, it is impact of trade and is thus affecting impact of public health. That is why more 1 month old or 2 month old kids are joining nursing home today. You cannot control your ordinary diarrhea or ordinary respiratory infection, upper respiratory infections, because already mother milk or the cattle milk is having, or the poultry meat is having antibiotic residue. No doubt about that. Presence of residue is always there. Whether the question is above the legal limit or below the legal limit. But it is reaching the babies, it is reaching the human life. So it is our duty to contain the use of antibiotics through this. You can clearly observe from the last year observations from our own of the university projects. You have E. coli 011 strain, 0.125, we say 0.01 to 1 microgram per number. Most of the antibiotic endoprostrin, most commonly used in poultry is endoprostrin, spareprostrin, leoprostrin. You see the satisfactory result is there, but if you have sulfonyl dichlorosurium, it is decreasing, response is decreasing based on the integrations. That is why we should not copy from foreign textbook or literature the dose inclusion in the diet, because although intensive poultry units are in large scale, we are through premix, we have delivered the antibiotics or feed and water, but the environment condition is totally different. The backyard farming is another sector. We don't differentiate the dose. It is a high time we should classify, reclassify the drug, reschedule the dosage schedule based on MIC value. Then only we will be successful to decline the use of antibiotics unnecessarily. Similarly, if you equalize 0119, if you assume hypothetically it is, suppose also the antibiotic MIC level is more, same dose is not working, it is not effective, it is 0.25 MIC value. Definitely our antibiotic is not working. I am talking about endoprostrin, which is the most commonly used antibiotic in India or in Karnataka in poultry industry today. So that means your antibiotic is such a higher class, antibiotic is ineffective against ordinary common organism like sulfonyl or typhoid E. coli. If the MIC value is 0.25 today, that means who is responsible? Who is responsible? For example, who is pointing out the responsibility? Because in the event of milk productions, in the event of in the nature of non-milk meat and milk productions, we have to use antibiotics. Even in agriculture, we are seeing now we have come to saliva or organic farming. We have to use fertilizer. We may achieve significant growth in that, but in high time in agriculture sector also, we are thinking of how to use avoid pesticides, how to use avoid other post harvest processing techniques. Or preservatives, etc. Because residues is out of the day, which adversely affect the market, a consumer pattern, health, or the international market. That is why it is our duty at least once in a year, concrete antibiotic policy at the state level or the country level, which antibiotic will use for next 5 years, most contagious disease, during viral outbreak, which antibiotics. And in layer birds, what are the allowed antibiotic we have to think of? In broiler birds, outbreak at the fat end of 35 days onwards, what are the ideal antibiotics? To contain chick mortality, what are the antibiotics? You have to reclassify and informally in their district or state or zonal level, at least southern zone, like Tamil Nadu, Kerala, and Andhra Karnataka border, the northeast, like that, at least 4 or 5 zones, if you reclassify the use of antibiotic usage pattern, definitely, all countries are doing same thing. Don't think all have banned and suddenly they get 0%. No, all have done experiment like this, and they didn't achieve a significant difference overnight. After 7-8 years, today Europe is enjoying by withdrawing one of the most commonly prescribed drugs in human medicines. Also in cattle, also in poultry, they also use tetracycline extensively. When they withdraw tests, they are not getting results. Totally they withdraw the tetracycline from human side and veterinary side, especially in poultry in Europe. in the around 90s, and they observed tremendous decline in MIC value, and they were able to contain outbreaks, bigger outbreaks, very effective in organized farms as well as in the small sectors also. That means both in human and animal sector, apparently they are getting beneficial result by withdrawing and restricting one drug, and the results are seen within 4-5 years. That is the order today. The MIC value pattern for the same anthropoxin and another cephalosporin but commonly used is drastically increased in this particular slide. You can see the slide which contains more of growth there. The MIC level is supposed to be at 0.1 but is going towards negative positive side, where it is tremendously into 0.3, 0.4, 0.5 like that. That means even with higher antibiotics, you cannot contain the infections because the environmental contamination is very huge. Similarly, when you talk about the loss international trade or the domestic trade on the organic pattern, if the export comes out of India, I am right, this is the latest data I am putting here for anthropoxylin, when they say 100 ppb is the limit in muscle, liver and kidney, and the European Economic Council, 100, 200, 300, almost same. We just copy from European and US FDA, little bit more as far as kidney is concerned. But you see, 3 days anthropoxylin definitely may not have any problem, but the problem is metabolite. But I can tell, you can understand, but the ground reality is the farmers, the small scale farmers, are the farms which do not have quality veterinarians, then they do not have this particular knowledge, which vary from one drug to another, one formulation to another, one industry to another industry formulations. You will end up in problem because somebody is in consumer chat of his own choice, somebody is in herbal drug as enjoying joys, somebody is in his own field formulation of finisher birds, then your pharmacokinetic or movement of drug is not in my control or your control. It takes your sole course of action in a given species of animals. That is why you have to be extremely careful. The MRO value, lesser than the prescribed MRO value, is the utmost duty. That is why the prescribed value of Part-1of2 ciprofloxacin is found in 96 hours after therapeutic administrations. Dr. Nadim has worked a lot on this extra therapeutic use of these drugs. Normally farmers do out of box. How much if he has excess, 2 times more, 3 times more, or if he has 4-5 days extra therapeutic administrations, what happens? So ultimately more and more use, more withdrawal product will be enhanced. The main compound is negative here, but the metabolite is tremendously concentration increased. That is why in disease setup, this is in healthy works. Understand, with all this book knowledge never works in practical, because we do research in healthy works, but when you do in a adversely affected, infected bird population, definitely it's when its condition of liver and kidney is not optimal, its half-life and its residual level automatically, without research I can tell, drastically increase or postponed. Limitation of antibiotics. Limitation of antibiotics is not the solution for containment of infections, because Alexander Fleming has thought in 1937 itself. Because unless you give importance to biosecurity measures, use of quality disinfectant and complete total antiseptic measures in every aspect, from farm to plate, antibiotic alone cannot cure. Remember, no antibiotic today, if anybody puts over it, is fast. No antibiotic work unless the animal has good immunity. If the birds have got good immunity, then only antibiotic works. The credit will always be given to antibiotic. No. If the animal has good nutrition, good immunity, particular cellular immunity, then automatically antibiotic works in a better way compared to a animal do not have good immune functions. But in reality, whether immune is depressed, whether nutrition problem, irrespective of that, we prescribe antibiotics without checking the quality of nutritions or the immune boosters or some revitalizers or antioxidants or stress control measures. We simply select antibiotic on our own, thinking that based on the MIC value also sometimes, some laboratory, but we do not understand antibiotic works under an immunosuppressed patient is different, antibiotic working under a viral outbreak is different, antibiotic working under high stress anemia is different, antibiotic working under extreme humid condition is totally different. That is why dosage also vary. Many a time we restrict to single dosage because there are Western literatures, cold country, environmental conditions, and controlled environmental conditions are rare birds and totally irrelevant. It is not only in poultry, even in large animals or in prescriptions as per your fancy, particularly in the rural sectors or unorganized sectors, because in organized sector everything is monitored. Quality control office is there, farm visits are there, and this rate is dependent upon the quality of the product what is selling to the owners. But thing is, in unorganized sector, but the resistance pattern won't differentiate, bacteria won't differentiate whether from organized sector or unorganized sectors. So you will see, prophylactic caution, that is why this we have to understand three sentences. What is required from the government or the private? We have to reclassify our use of that. One is prophylactic use, one is therapeutic use, one is thinking that outbreak is bird flu outbreak is some other state, border state. What prophylaxis I can take, or some outbreak of disease is there in neighboring state, what prophylaxis measures, metaphylaxis use. Before onset of infection, what I can think of use of antibiotic. If you have three classification, very clear classifications, species wise, I think without any hesitation, 60 to 70% problem in antibiotic residue we can avoid. With panic only use antibiotics, whether required or not, many a time you may agree, industrialists definitely will agree. With panic only, many even big farmers also with panic only thinking that I may get the outbreak, you use antibiotics more and more. And it may not be required or effective also. And second problem is consequently you get more resistance problem next time when you use the same antibiotics. Therapeutic, how should I go? That means every time you have to reclassify based on the current MSC value, we have to select best 5 formulations. No matter who, whether produce is not an important criteria, just 5 molecules you select for therapeutic purpose. You try next 5 years, you depend upon these molecules only. Come to a conclusion, make a policy. Then definitely next 5, other than 5 years, it is not a small achievement, it is a big achievement. Not only for poultry farmers or the poultry sector, it is also a big achievement for the large animal practitioners, pet animal practitioners. So because the resistance level in the organism, some of the gram-negative organism is common, and automatically the resistance level will go down and they may get the better effect with the smaller therapeutic dose. Similarly, this is mostly not from organized sector, but I must tell because I am asked to cover up limitations and this misuse of antibiotics. Pure chemicals should not be used at any cost, whether legally, you should not entertain the use of pure chemicals. Because each antibiotic has got its own gut pH for which maximum optimal efficacy, what they call in pharmacology, bioavailability. Pure drugs, if it is mixed, then how to contain resistance, number one thing. And it may not be able to get sufficient concentration in the blood also, because you are not given the correct rectifications. When you say formulation, it has got rectifier, pH, stabilizers, formulation and presentation techniques are different. They are well defined technique. Now most of the medication through pellet also we can give anthropoxamine, etc. That is why this absorption is a time dependent fashion, and a particular 1 inch or 1 centimeter piece of intestine is getting the absorption of the drugs. That 1 centimeter is so much important for pharmacology for maximum efficacy. If you use pure drugs, don't think that you will be succeeding, because over a period of time you may get problem, especially in outbreak. The antibiotic may not be absorbed, maybe it simply comes in the excreta, or if it is absorbed, definitely at the cost of gut health, some injury, some epithelial damage, villi damage, and nutrition absorbed, definitely will problem have growth problem also. Over a period of time, you may get growth deficiency or improper development of the muscles also. And the, you may, instead of 37 or 38 or 42 days, it may get more time to get maximum body weight. That means benefits is less, and legally also it is not permitted. Pure drugs should not be used. Indiscriminate use, how to contain the antibiotic residue. Antibiotic, as per the prescription policy, as per the label dose only we should use. Most of us will prescribe unlabeled dose. 10 ml per liter, you go 20 ml liter. And it is beneficial, then next time 30 ml per liter. The farmer is, as per his richness. Because we have to, the laborers or the supervisor, we have to understand it more and more is not just like a tonic. Even tonic in excess also is dangerous. That is what American India started using in pregnant ladies, and American India in excess also cause abortions, one of the our misconceptions. That is also this. That is why we have to understand each drug has got its own. Up to optimal level, we can use thinking that more benefit, more bacteria will die. Here you are getting loss the other way. And especially we have labeled drugs for meat breeds of birds, are broilers only, and special drugs for layer birds. And early stages we are supposed to feed, then we feed it at the later milk, milk peak production stage where we need some different antibiotics, and the quality of eggs also will go down, and the content of antibiotic also into the recipes in the yolk, and we don't differentiate. Some antibiotics, definitely most of them we can safely use in layers also, but we never understand during peak productions we use certain drugs which are highly liquid soluble, reaching the yolk where it is highly getting high concentrations. Problem is in somewhere in the body, but we will be in the yolk only. Most of the antibiotics in the yolk only. Probably if you use certain other water soluble antibiotics and you can contain acid infection or some other infection in a better way, even by spending less money, but thinking that bigger antibiotic works better, we will go fascinated by the slogans of the what you call the business trend or the general trend of higher antibiotics. It is totally fast. There is no like what antibiotic has got, it's so clear, it's so condition for maximal efficacy and actions. Under pus, under acidity, under air sac infection, under mycoplasma, outside the label, many a time look, air-based result is misleading. Air-based result gives very good inhibitory zones. When you actually administer or do the feed and water, the conducive atmosphere is not there. Because if it is the septicemia conditions, here septicemia conditions you are not seeing, only culture media under ideal conditions. You have to think, that means both microbiologist help and pharmacological app, pharmacokinetic data has to be integrated, which antibiotic formulation is meant for these things. Many formulations in the market, antibacterial plus antibiotic combinations, they are antagonist, except in few cases. They are antagonist. Jebert's law, it is not my law or anybody's law, Jebert's law. And bacteriostatic and bactericidal, except few combinations, are totally violent to use, either in large animals or poultry or pet animals. They never works. I think Ramesh is much better. We use intramammary interbacterial and intravenous antibiotics. It is antagonistic natures. Intrauterine antibacterial, a parenteral antibiotics. It is antagonistic nature. If you use both, it is very good. Except in specific condition, special organisms like Brucella, or this thing, the combination is there. Otherwise, in routine practice, 90% cases, we have to avoid by Jebert's law. That is what they mean poultry. Similarly, it is high time. We have to integrate the use of coccidiostats and antibiotics. Because new generation antibiotic, everybody is busy, everybody wants long acting. When short acting goes nicely, even large animals, people come with long acting formulations. People going nowadays with pellet medications. So when to the pellet, animal is getting, the bird is getting the daily medications. And other side is getting coccidiostats or a stress controller or a revitalizer or antioxidants at the marketing stage. Definitely their antibiotic kinetics will vary. That is why there is no rules in our country. Each country, more than use other Malaysia, Singapore, they use antibiotics. They have got clear guidelines. Very, very clear. If this is the herbal formulations, what are the antibiotics? If this is the long-acting antibiotics, which are the higher coccidiostatic that they can entertain? They are different. That is why, don't think that their BP is free from antibiotic. They are 100% has got antibiotic, but definitely less than the mRNA level. They see that a fixed combination, match fixing. This drug A plus B plus C don't have mRNA value. That is a combination because disease free zone overnight we cannot create. Till then, you do your next 5 years in this workshop, take a better word like this, implement it in this manner in a smaller zone, a one district or a group of poultry farms in the border district or a large poultry sector, an integrated poultry sector will adopt precisely. Bring the small scale farmers into your farm and let them visit, let them grow, give some incentives, entertain them, then observe the data for next 3 years, monitor it. Definitely antibiotic risk will be reduced and one day you can definitely work out from the market. Otherwise, it is very, very difficult. We only keep on talking, but action should be there, ground reality should be there, work with policy should be there, with enforcement agency, it can be removed. Even in Europe also find difficulty in the beginning. Many protests were there, poultry farmers, poor farmers in those countries. And ultimately they succeeded convincing them through extension education program. Farm demonstrations were held, including safety the scientists from school, colleges to village. And that is the big story was there. Then they were able to pass the legislation in the council and get ratified in 1/1/2006. It is not easy. Because that is why today they are enjoying the benefit of banning certain life-saving antibiotics. You have to reclass. Those antibiotics should be, it is the high time in India also should go for this. See, there are common principles. If somebody asks me, some people free information on it, I will take. I got problem, I have to use it. Yes, damage is there, reduce the damage. I am hit with the birds the last 7 days or 3 days, market is not there, some festival season. But birds are dying, humanitarian ground also, as a veterinarian, I should give the reply also, or as a poultry consultant, you have to give the reply. At least, switch out the water soluble antibiotics. You have to reduce the mortality, contain the mortality, reduce your order. Why to use higher antibiotics at that time? Or you cannot reach, 7 days you cannot reach the farm. Nobody is supporting there, no labor problem. So you have to reclassify. Some of the antibiotics are very simple principle, how to avoid resistance symptoms, how to reduce the resistance. It is not the prevention of antibiotic, how to reduce the antibiotic. Next 5 years, step by step you have to go. You have to reclassify them, need to maintain constant MIC. This is, risk is there. No super, proper supervision is there. So, select these group of drugs. India is very lucky that you got whatever the drug you like, antibiotic is readily available in the market. Post-antibiotic effect, you want to skip, you are not sure, you are not tried, don't want to try all the 15,000 months, you don't want to medicate. Then you go for such post-antibiotic effect. That means even the MIC level fall below in the body, they can contain the infections. That is, you got so much antibiotic in that section also. That means each class of drug will show principle of pharmacokinetic as well as pharmacodynamic implication. Unless we integrate these two principles, we will not be succeed just by prescribing the antibiotics. Similarly, bacteriostatic, today tetracycline, when I am a student, definitely I will show the notes, bacteriostatic. No, it is bacteriostatic. For all purpose in India, consider bacteriostatic drug, including tetracyclines, oxytetracycline, entire group. Even water classified, classified, bacteriostatic also started classifying in India as bacteriostatic. It is true. Under ideal condition, laboratory condition, one or two like protease or some susceptible organs, so gram, highly bactericidal. But in general, in reality, clinical side, whereas poultry or large animals, it is a bacteriostatic drugs. We should not carry away antibiotics. Antibiotics should have only three principles. Original from the natural molecules, able to be at micromolar concentrations, and should kill the organisms. With these principles, but normally we say every drug has antibiotic, antibiotic. The term itself is misleading into the market. The term itself is misleading in the market. Whether it's a chemist or a biologist or a prescriber, everybody is talking about, everybody talking in antibiotic, but never talk about it is antibacterial, this is antimicrobial, this is a narrow spectrum, like that we never reclassify. Similarly,